are very, very famous dances from Venezuela. Antonio Lauro was one of the great guitarist composers. There's a lot of them now. But these are so famous. You probably know these tunes, even if you don't know that they were Venezuelan waltz number three or whatever. And they all have nicknames that he named for his daughters. There's Natalia, and there's
Tama.
What was the other one?
Adriana?
Yes, exactly. Yeah. And they're just charming. And somehow we added flute to them, and I don't know how we did that, but this is a flute part. It's not original.
Interesting transcription.
No, yeah. Anyway, enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you.
have musical chairs here and to provide a space for some of the other arts groups on Staten Island to perform, but also our mission is to preserve the art and culture of Tibet and Tibetan history and Tibetan culture. So we're so happy that you're here with us in the space. I have to do my job and let you know that that large Buddha that's sitting very peacefully and this other Buddhist deity, I believe it's Avalokiteshvara, the Buddha of Compassion, have actually just come out for this concert. They had been in storage for about 30 years, and so you're among the first folks to see them. They just got back here this week, so I'm happy that you're all here. And thank you to Musical Chairs for, again, performing in our intimate space here. So happy to have you. Please enjoy the setting of the museum, and I hope to see you back here for another event.
So just to thank you again all for coming out tonight. This is our last performance of season 11. Our Roaring Chorus program will be performing with our choral director, Beth McCullough, on June 15th. So I'm sure if you're on the email list, you'll know all about that. Otherwise, we'll see you next season. I want to thank Hilary Purrington for being our composer this evening. And, having us and just our staff and crew for having a great year. Thank you all for helping and being there when times are crazy. So enjoy the last piece.